Hello, my friends. Welcome back to another episode of So now that our apples have been cooked so nice with the cinnamon and sugar, I am ready with my homemade puff pastry dough that we made in my last video. This is how it looks. Beautiful. And we don't need all these, so I'm gonna cut some of it. There we go. And the ones that we don't need can go back in the fridge. I'm gonna sprinkle a little bit flour, not too much, just to make sure that it doesn't stick. Okay, and I'm gonna start rolling our puff pastry. That is a beautiful puff pastry. You know, I'm gonna get it closer so that you can see how beautiful it is. Do you see the lines? I don't know if you can see all the lines. This is the homemade puff pastry we made. And I will make sure to link the video of this puff pastry so that you can make your own at home if you would like. If you don't have one and if you went to the store and you couldn't find it. This is a beautiful puff pastry that we made in the last video, and now we're gonna use it for our tart tatine. Tart tatine, a French cake, which here in the States you would call an upside down cake. The Tatine sisters are the ones that invented it, and it's called Tart Tatine on behalf of the Tatine sisters. Beautiful. My oven is already on and it's heated, and it's preheated for 350. I'm gonna use this to help me lift up the puff pastry. There we go. Beautiful. I'm gonna keep it here so that we can have room, so that we can have enough room to put our apples. And there's our pan with all the apples. And all I'm doing now, I'm gonna take my puff pastry and I'm gonna cover the pan. I'm using the knife to help me cut all the excess dough that we don't need. Just like that.